it was probably in the 70s, sort of mid-70s, when there were three or four what proved to be quite significant collaborations. They happened then. I mean, John Yeoman and I had been working together. I got into doing some books of my own. Even then, when I did that first book, picture book that I did of my own, Patrick, I didn't, you know, I should have been doing the next one as soon as that one was in the pipeline. I didn't know you had to do that. I was waiting for somebody to tell me, yeah, I've got to do another one, you know, kind of thing. And in fact, that was published by Tom Maschler, Jonathan Cape, and he's someone who's over the years been very good at saying, what about the next one? And once we got into the habit, I mean, as I gave the finished version of the finished pictures of one to him, he would say, and what ideas have you got about the next one? But that's one of those things, you know, when there are certain questions you get asked, like, where do you get your ideas from? And my own ideas, that's quite a difficult question. They come from different places, and really, I don't know. But the other answer is I get them from authors, and that's one. I could do a book of my own every year or two, but I like to work more than that, and I do three or four or five books a year, or I have done, and I couldn't do that without authors. And what is nice is the diversity of authors, and I think it was sort of 73, 74, 75, 76, sort of around about then, that looking back, I realised that some new relationships and collaborations started. One was with Russell Hoban, and Tom Maschler, Jonathan Cape, sent me, I think he actually sent me three manuscripts and said, look at these and see what you think about that. And I admired Russell Hoban's writing already. And these were all very nice, but there was one which was the one that we did, called How Tom Beat Captain Najork and His Hired Sportsmen, which is a wonderful title. And I said, can I do something about this? And I was invited to do a sample. Always a difficult thing to do because, you know, there is a kind of process of development where you find out what the drawings ought to look like. I did quite a lot of samples. I mean, I did quite a lot of drawings for it, and it was. I mean, it was about three or four pages of typing, and it was. It seemed wonderful to me because it was like as though it was the book that you wanted to illustrate. You didn't know it existed, and you could not have written it yourself. But it was like ideas that I wanted to draw. And so I did these roughs and sample drawings. And then there was a little wait while I waited to find out whether I was going to be commissioned to do it. And I thought, I'm not sure how I can cope with this if I'm not going to be allowed to do it, but I was anyway. And that was fascinating, I think.